Dude needs to lay off the speed. What is going on, YouTube? It is LordZhangFei, bringing you another video of my hybrid collection from my Legacy D2 characters. This one is super fun and blends together Frenzy, Throw, and Wolf all into one nice little package and does some things that are pretty extraordinary. Definitely a super fun build. Go ahead and get our summons together. Probably like summons. What are you talking about? We're gonna be using summons as a barb, as weird as that sounds. I love the way they look in this game. Now it's I love me some animals and dogs, so it's nice having some pets. But they're really gonna serve a pretty important purpose, especially with using frenzy, because when you're when we're throwing, we got to get our dudes out in front of us, and then we're never getting attacked, of course, So you can play this like a throw barb if you'd like. The benefits are much better if you use frenzy and throw and all of it kind of at once, Make sure you get these guys, of course, hit with that battle order. So with frenzy, we're going to charge up our frenzy here with our weapons that we're throwing with, and then transform into a wolf and get crazy attack speed. It's actually really clever what I'm doing here. Let me show you the items and show you the goods. I just wanted to get my army together. Hold this up. All right, so here's the skills we're gonna want to use. Oops. Okay, you're going to want to max Frenzy and Double Swing. And the cool thing is, Double Swing is going to be a synergy to Double Throw. So you kind of inherently get this synergy that, a lot of people who use Frenzy don't use, of course. So we're going to try to take the best advantage of that we can. For the Combat Masteries, this is where a ton of our points are going to be put into. We're going to be maxing Throw and Polearm, and this is totally up to you, what you do with the next 20 points here, because you could just leave it at that and then max out battle orders and you don't have 2000 health. So if you're super hating on the health that this guy has, because he has super low health, but there's a reason for it in my opinion, and I like using a variety of weapons. So I'll put 10 points into Mace Mastery and Axe Mastery. That's totally up to you, though. I think with the Lacerator, you'll only need to do Axe Mastery. Yeah. So, if you play just the Lacerator, because I actually have a throw weapon that I use, a GG throw weapon. But either way, totally based on how you really want to play this. The other one's 1 point, and of course, all of those nice increased speed. Increase resistance, all that jazz. And I do 1 point into all of that. I don't feel I need a lot of health, since we're transforming into a wolf. When you stack it with battle orders, you have like 3k health, and this guy kills shit so fast that there's no need to have a lot of health, because he's always gaining health on the go also. But the stat points, I put a base of 165 vitality. You could put all your points into vitality too if you wanted. You could probably get like 7k health with this character if you did it right. But you're gonna lose a lot of damage for that, and survivability is not really my thing when it comes to these max strength builds. So if you'll notice, I put all my points into strength, and then no points into dexterity. We get ours from our charms, and we're also going to be using an infinity. And you're probably like, dude, you're not even doing elemental damage, why would you ever use an infinity on a melee character? And for something like this, where it's really heavy damage oriented, yeah, we could get something that would benefit us with damage, and sure, that would increase our damage, of course, but when it comes down to it, man, infinity is minus 85% to enemy defense. It's always going to outweigh all the other polearms, in my opinion. I mean, it's, I hate to say that because it's so godly, but with that in mind, I don't have to put any points into dexterity, and I'm going to hit every single time. And that will always benefit using something else, in my opinion, you know. But here's the gear. We're going to be using Fortitude Sacred Armor, because again, it's max strength build, so why not get the Sacred Armor? WolfHowl, of course, to transform into wolf, but we're also going to be using those Direwolf charges pretty often. It costs a little bit to repair them. I don't think it's as bad as like a teleport staff, but it costs around, I think, 150, maybe 200k to repair an empty one. But WolfHowl is just a really good item in general. If you are going to try to, you know, mess around with this build, you know, a 664, 665, that's fine too, because honestly, werewolf just kind of benefits your attack rating. So, hell, even a 663. I don't know, if you're using infinity, it doesn't really make much of a difference, but I would definitely try to get one that's 66 on the feral and the lycanthropy. For the main weapon, the lacerator, you know, I have two lacerators on right now because I feel like that's going to be the stepping stone to this build and what you want. I also have this super awesome weapon here that was given to me by my buddy Xeno Gear. So if you're checking this video out, Xeno, thank you, man. Super awesome rare item that we'll probably never have something similar like this in the new game. Again, these are all my old legacy characters, man, so I don't even have this stuff on Battle.net, but I couldn't part way with these characters, so I brought them to single player here. But something like this is what you'd want to go for, you know, and I've seen even godlier than this too. That's the best one I got, and I love it. And here is the money maker, a low Zod Tomb Reaver. Okay, and you're probably like wondering what's going on with that. What we're doing is we're charging up Frenzy, and we're getting Frenzy to give us the increased attack speed bonus that we need, because that attack speed bonus gets applied to the base of your weapon from Frenzy, the boost you get. So if we get our boost up, I have it in my notes here, I think it's 40, where is it? ...44% increased attack speed is added to the base of the weapon when we're charged up on Frenzy. So what we're doing is we are getting Frenzy charged up, switching over to Wolf, and we have 5 seconds to like wreak as much havoc as we can, because we're sitting at 92% critical strike, which is something that can't be done as a druid or any other class, where you have the max increased attack speed with almost 100% critical strike. On top of that, we also get the 30% chance from our passive, but that's only going to affect about 2 or 3% in the long term, just the way it works. So 95% critical strike with this build. So when our damage is 11, 12k, you know, we're doing double that almost every hit. It's the only instance in the time, you can, only instance in the game that can ever happen. We're going to be using either Steel Rends or Dracs. You know, I'm playing with Dracs right now. I like using Steel Rends though too. Stringy Ears, definitely, with the damage reduced and the magic damage reduction. That's super good. And then Gore Riders, you know, want to try to get as much more deadly strike as we can for the build. And Highlords for the amulet. And we do have a minimum damage, resistance, replenish life ring down there. I kind of wanted a little bit more mana. Mana burn guys are kind of bumming me out, so. And then a Raven Frost, of course. And see, if you want to take the throw aspect out of it, you know, I would recommend using an Ethereal Stormlash and a Phoenix Scourge, and then max the mace side out of it. This is a super fun build. We'll play around with that before I get out of here too. You know, bone hue, this is something you can use also. That's pretty cool because there's no other instance in the game where you can hit the max attack speed with bone hue at all. And with this build, you actually can. You can't do it with an ethereal one, unfortunately, but I wanted to play around with the corpse explosion charges. You know, we're using infinity too, so you can actually swap this out instead of a tomb reaver. If you really wanted to try this out and you didn't have the availability to get a tomb reaver, you know, you can definitely do this with bone hue. Just make sure you put 215 increased attack speed jewels in it. And it's pretty fun because you have another video from a previous Diablo with a very similar build like this. This one's tweaked out just a little bit compared to that one, but oh, I just noticed the text was wrong on all that one, and I wonder if it was wrong on all of them. Sorry guys, I've been trying to crank these things out. Now we're good. Okay, so that's the build. Let's get this out of here. All right, we'll check it out. We'll go, and since we don't teleport, again, I have, of course, you know, you gotta rock this teleport amulet in your thing. You know, that way when you're doing bail or whatever, and he's right across the way, you don't have to walk a mile. Just slap that on real quick. So again, I can't stress enough, you know, the minions are gonna help out, man, because they're just taking hits, taking damage. They all got wiped out right there because I didn't have a battle order. But to be honest, you know, burning souls, they always hurt, so I'll take the loss. We'll get him going. And you know, you don't have to play super low health like this. I prefer to, just because I feel like maximizing the damage is what is going to be the most beneficial, you know. You know, immune to physicals too with the amplify damage that does break their immunity, so that helps out. But I will say immune to physicals are kind of a pain, especially if it's that many harpies. But I mean, if you'll notice, we just breeze right by them. That's the beauty about this frenzy. You can just jet past that. I wanted to try to tweak a way to make that happen, but it just seemed like more of a burden to try to do that. Because we are rocking infinity, so adding an elemental aspect to it. I mean, the corpse explosion was good, but that's not a very reliable form of damage to like kill a group of harpies like that. What is this, like double spawn on them? Jesus. Here we go. See, we'll go ahead and do some wolf action. You guys can check it out. I mean, you hit everything once and it dies. This thing is an absolute beast. The double damage with Tomb Reaver is very, very strong. Man, that decrepify is really bumming me out. You know, it makes me wonder if this would make, you know, I don't know dick about PvP compared to a lot of other streamers and people. So I wouldn't claim to know all this, but its build seems like it could definitely have some PvP aspect to it because it just seems so surprising. It's like, oh, whoa, I'm a frenzy. Just kidding. And then you hit him with a 22k max damage Tomb Reaver blast. I mean, that sounds pretty cool. So I may venture more into PvP as time goes on, especially with some of these new items and new builds that are coming out. I'm sure the assassin's gonna have quite a, ooh, my goodness, I'm sure the assassin is going to have a lot of new awesome builds. I've seen the patch notes from today that they were saying, and it says that if you have a charge, it will hit every time, like smite. And if that's the case, then kickers are going to be so overpowered, it's going to be ridiculous. Because as long as you just keep that one charge, if you hit every time, there's so many awesome things you can do to guarantee. If you can guarantee a hit and not have to worry anything about attack rating, That's money, dude. So we'll have to see how all that pans out. Haven't really been doing a lot of the shapeshifting just because I'm trying to get to the throne room, so. What I definitely would recommend though is that when you're on your Tomb Reaver, you leave your skill set to something different. You know? I would not recommend leaving it on the werewolf because you want to make sure you don't get it confused. It's really hard to tell sometimes. I mean, obviously the Feral Rage will be right there, but you only have 5 seconds, so. Just want to always get in the habit of only doing it when I'm in on my axis here. Get it nice and charged up. Get the amplified damage. And then we just like one-shot everything. It's too bad there wasn't a way to get like Dragonflight onto this character somehow, you know what I mean? If they came out with some crazy new rune word that had Dragonflight. Oops. That would be totally awesome. Damn, those guys melted all those summons. So it's definitely not a conventional build here, guys. I feel you on that. And I gotta also say before I forget that leaving Howl on a hotkey is always a really good idea on this build because sometimes there can be shit going real wrong and nothing will help you out more than being able to just get away. I think a lot of people don't ever use that or keep that on a hotkey. And that's one of the Barbarian's best skills is to just, you know, make everybody howl away. All right, let's see how well we do against these guys. Stack them up with amp, switch. Man, I'm getting hit and this faster hit recovery is killing me. That was kind of bad. Got hit too many times and got hit into faster hit recovery, so normally that does go better. It's one of the shittiest things with Frenzy is just, you know, you really gotta just take all the hits because they're coming. All right, let's go ahead and get charged up here and see how Bale does against 100% critical strike damn near. It's chunking him pretty good considering there's no crushing blow really. I have like 15% crushing blow. Definitely faster if you have like double last wish and all that shit for sure. But that's just crushing blow in general. I'll show you what it looks like when you don't use the lacerators. You definitely do a shitload more damage, that is for sure. Switch him over to Ethereal Stormlash. Nah. Oops. I guess they're gonna make it different, the attack speed different with Frenzy too, to where you don't just get the bonus from the main hand, if you will. So we'll see how that works out. We will go river. It's fun when you can do it real fast and you get the and you don't get hit and you can get the that's run walk speed from Feral Rage with Frenzy, even if it's like a real short blast, if you can get it and you run so fast, it's crazy. see how fast that dude runs. Definitely a unique build. Combining Wolf with this is cool, and you know, being able to, I've barely yet to explore, if I'm being honest, the whole combining the attack speed from Frenzy for a little blast on Wolf, you know, because yeah, I mean, see how bad we put down Hephaestus right there? They got to think that's with no crushing blow either. I really like getting these skeletons too. I feel like this build's full of style. It's not too expensive either. I mean, look at it. Fortitude, WolfHowl, Tomb Reaver, you know, dual lacerators. Those, I mean, they're ethereal minor, but honestly, they don't really need to be. And I, and personally, you know, when I play it, I probably would prefer playing it like this if I'm going to play more casual, but oops. But let me know what you think of the build in the comments. I will go ahead and show a video of all this dude's original gear from the legacy character. And we will get out of here. You guys take it easy. And I'll check you out on the next one. Peace.